Chapter 20 of the Book of Jubilees.
And in the 42nd Jubilee, in the first year of the second week, Abraham called Ishmael. In the year 2052, or 2045 A.M., and his 12 sons, and Isaac, and his 2 sons, and the 6 sons of Keturah, and their sons. And he commanded them that they should observe the way of Yahweh, and they should work righteousness, and love each his neighbor, and act on this manner amongst all men, that they should each so work, so walk with regard to them as to do judgment and righteousness on the earth, that they should circumcise their sons according to the covenant which he made with them, and not deviate to the right hand or to the left of all the paths which Yahweh had commanded us, and that we should keep ourselves from all fornication and uncleanness, and renounce from amongst us all fornication and uncleanness. And if any woman or maid commit fornication amongst you, burn her with fire, and let them not commit fornication with her after their eyes and their heart, and let them not take to themselves wives from the daughters of Canaan. For the seed of Canaan is rooted out of the land. And he told them of the judgment of the giants and the judgment of the Sodomites, how they had been judged on the account of their wickedness, and had died on the account of their fornication and uncleanness and mutual corruption through fornication. Guard yourself from all fornication, uncleanness, and all pollution of sin, lest you make your name a curse and your whole life a hissing, and all your sons be destroyed by the sword, and ye become a curse like Sodom, and all your remnant as the sons of Gomorrah. I implore you, my sons, love God of heaven, and cleave you to all your commandments, and walk not after their idols, and after their uncleanness, and make not yourselves molten graven gods, for their vanity, which is emptiness, and there is no spirit in them, for they are work of man's hands, and all who trust in them trust in nothing. Serve them not, nor worship them, but serve ye the Most High God, and worship him continually, and hope for his countenance always, and work up righteousness, and righteousness before him, that he may have pleasure in you, and grant you his mercy, and send rain upon you morning and evening, and bless all your work which he has wrought upon the earth, and bless any bread and thy water, and bless the fruit of your womb, and the fruit of thy hand, and the herbs of the cattle, and the flocks of thy sheep. And ye will be a blessing upon the earth, and all the nations of the earth will desire you, and bless your son in my name, that they may be blessed as I am. He gave Ishmael to his sons, and the sons of Keturah, the gifts, and sent them away. From Isaac his son, he gave everything to Isaac his son, and Ishmael his son, and the sons of Keturah and their sons went together and dwelt from Paran to entering into Babylon in the land which is towards the east facing the desert. And these mingled with each other, and their name was called Arabs and Ishmaelites. Chapter 21 of the Book of Jubilees. And in the 16th year of the 17th week of the Jubilee, Abraham calls Isaac his son. This was the year of 2057 or 2050 A.M., and commanded him, saying, I have become old, and know not the days of my death, and I am full of the days. And behold, I am 175 years old, and throughout all the days of my life I have remembered Yahweh, and sought with all my heart to do his will, and to walk upright in all his ways. My soul has hated idols, and I those have meant on all those who transgress his commandments and despise his covenants. And do thou, my son, observe his commandments and his ordinance and his judgments, and walk not after the abominations, and after the engraved images, and after the molten images, and eat no blood at all of the animals or cattle of any bird that flies in the heaven. And if thou doest slay a victim as an accepted peace offering, slay ye it, and pour out the blood upon the altar, and all the fat of the offering offer on the altar with fine flour, and meat offering mingled with it, oil with it, drink offering, offer them all together on the altar of burnt offering. It is a sweet savor before Yahweh. And thou will offer a fat sacrifice,
a thank offering
upon the fire which is upon the altar, and a fat which is on the belly, and all the fat in the inwards and into the kidneys, and all the fat that is upon them, and upon the loins and the liver, thou shalt remove, together with the kidneys, and offer all these a sweet savor acceptable before Yahweh, with its meat offering and with its drink offering, and a sweet savor in the bread offering unto Yahweh, and eat its meat on the day and on the second day, and let not the sun on the second day go down upon it until it is eaten. And let nothing be left over on the third day, for it is not acceptable, for it is not approved. And let not no longer be eaten. And all who eat thereof will bring sin upon themselves. For this I have found it written in the books of the forefathers, and in the words of Enoch, and in the words of Noah. And upon thy obligations thou shalt sow salt, and not the salt of the covenant be lacking in it, thy obligations before Yahweh. And as regards the wood of the sacrifice, beware lest thou bring other wood for the altar in addition to these: cypress, bay, almond, fir, pine, cedar, savin, fir, olive, myrrh, laurel. And these woods of the wood lay upon the altar under the sacrifice, as to have been tested as their appearance. And do not lay upon any split or dark wood, but harden and clean without fault, a sound new growth, and do not lay whereunto old wood, for its fragrance is gone, for there is no longer fragrance in it as before. Besides these kinds of wood, there is none other that thou shalt place on the altar, for the fragrance is dispensed, and the smell of its fragrance is gone, not up to heaven. Observe the commandment and do it, my son, that thou mayest be upright in all thy deeds, and at all times be clean in thy body, and wash thyself with water before thou approachest the offer at the altar, and wash thy hands and thy feet before thou drawest near to the altar. And when thou art done sacrificing, wash thy hands and thy feet. And let no blood appear upon you nor upon your clothes. Be thou guard, my sons, against blood, and be on thy guard exceedingly, cover with dust, and do not eat any blood, for it is soul. Eat no blood whatsoever, and take no gift of blood of man, lest it be shed with impiety, without judgment, for it is a blood that is shed that causes the earth in sin, and the earth cannot be cleansed from the blood of man, save by the blood of him who shed it. And take no present or gift from the blood of man, blood for blood, that thou mayest be accepted before Yahweh, the Most High God, for he is the defense of the good, and that thou mayest be preserved for all evil, and that he may save thee from every kind of death. I see, my son, that all the works of the children of men are sin and wickedness, and with their deeds are uncleanness and abomination and a pollution, and there is no uprightness in them. Beware lest thou shouldest walk in their ways and tread in their paths, and sin a sin in death before the Most High God. Else he will hide his face from thee and give thee back into the hands of thy transgression, and the root thee out of the land, and thy seed likewise from under the heaven, and thy name and thy seed shall perish from all the whole earth. Turn away from all your deeds and all your uncleanness, and observe the ordinance of the Most High God, and do his will, and be upright in all things, and he will bless thee in all thy deeds, and will rise up from thee a plant of righteousness through all the earth, throughout all the generations of the earth. And my name and thy name shall not be forgotten under the heaven forever. Now go, sons, in peace. May the Most High God, my God, and thy God strengthen thee to do his will. And may he bless all thy seed and the residue of thy seed for generations forever, and all righteous blessings, and that thou mayest be blessings on all the earth. And he went out from them rejoicing.